Good day, brethren. You are welcome to another hour of the Word of God for Bowen University. I am reading from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 18, verse 1. The scripture says, one day Jesus told his disciples a story to show that they should always pray and never give up. The topic I want to share with us is titled, The Need of This Moment. The Need of This Moment. It is the need for us to pray. It is the need for us to engage in serious prayer like never before. There is nothing like too much prayer or prayer overdose. Beloved, when Jesus spoke in parable in this passage we read, he said men ought to pray and not to lose heart. A version of the Bible says men ought to pray and not to turn cowards. If you are not praying at this time of the challenge that we have in this nation, then you are actually turning a coward. Beloved, prayer is an opportunity for you and I to simply talk to God. It's an opportunity for us to act in the place of worship. It is an opportunity for us to demonstrate the Savior's need for people, the Savior's desire for people. Leonard Ravenhill says that prayer is like an oxygen that we breathe in our Christian lives. According to him, prayer is to a Christian what capital is to the businessman. So prayer is essential relationship that shows our love for God and our commitment to God Almighty. Beloved, why should we pray? We are commanded to pray. Multiple times in the scripture, we read that we are to be in continual prayer. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, from verse 16 to 17. I read, the Bible says, always be joyful, never stop praying. The Bible says we should always be joyful and never stop praying. In a moment like this, we need prayer. Prayer to conquer fear, prayer to conquer the circumstance that we find ourselves. In fact, the situation we find ourselves demands that we should pray. Philippians 4, 6 to 7, Ephesians 6, 18 and 19. And in Luke, Jesus spoke about a parable that we need to pray. Beloved, when we pray, it gives God the glory in our life. Prayer is a way to serve God. Prayer is a way to sincerely bring our desires, our understanding, our plea before the Lord. Through prayer, we have the privilege to glorify Him and praise God in every circumstance and situation. Beloved, it helps us to overcome pain. It helps us to, you know, to face this COVID-19. Jesus asked Peter to pray. When? For him to get strength in overcoming temptation. So as we are faced with this COVID-19 situation, brethren, wherever you are, what I desire from you is to give yourself to prayer. Prayer is essential if we have to overcome. By prayer, we will be able to demonstrate our heart desire to God. We'll be able to demonstrate strong decisions we are taking, particularly concerning the situation that we have found ourselves in this nation. In prayer, we are able to bring our request, our complaint, our plea before the Lord God Almighty. It is therefore essential for you to pray. In Matthew 7:7, the Bible says, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. He said, whoever knocks, whoever asks will receive. Whoever knock will find the door open to him. This is an opportunity for us to knock and intercede for our nation. Intercede for people. Intercede for our students who are on holidays. Intercede for staff. Intercede for every person in this school. It is essential for us to pray. Beloved, prayer helps us to discern God's will. If you go back to John chapter 5, verse 14 to 15, 15 particularly, tells us that God desired that his will be done in our life in communion. So therefore, brethren, we need to stand up and pray. Prayer is the mechanical work we can use at this time to quench this pandemic that we are faced with. Beloved, according to R.C. Sproul, the goal of prayer is godliness born of obedience to Christ. Obedience unlocks the riches of Christian experience. Prayer is what prompts and nurtures obedience, putting the heart of a person, before the Lord, bringing understanding of spiritual situation. So if you are not praying, you are actually jeopardizing your life. Beloved, wherever you are, I want you to rise up and let us pray together. Let us arise and pray for our nation. Let's pray for our students, that even as they are on holiday, they will never, lose track of God in their life. Prayer helps us to purify our heart. It is the only one thing that can cause us to attract divine presence, to attract divine intervention in our situation. The social media is agog with a lot of things that are scary. You hear all kinds of news here and there. But I don't want you to depend on social media. I want you to depend on God's media. God's media is the most acceptable thing. Bowenites, Bowenians, workers in Bowen, I plead with you. Let us join God in the place of prayer. Please, as I round up, I pray that the Lord God Almighty will release the spirit of prayer mightily upon you, and that I ask for a refreshing presence of the Spirit of God to come upon you. As you pray, may the Spirit take you deeper into an experience that you yourself will come out with the assurance that yes, you have met the Lord at the place of prayer, and that the Lord God Almighty has heard you. It is my prayer this day that the hand of the Lord will come upon us as a community, and we take away this pandemic, we destroy it from its root, and grant us good and sound health. I pray that throughout this season, we will not lose anyone to this pandemic in this community. The hand of the Lord will perfect everything that concerns us, and it will beautify our life with long life and good health, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for listening. The Lord bless you. The Lord uphold you. The Lord guide you. The Lord fill you with new and fresh anointing in prayer. Thank you very much. God bless you.